What's happening, y'all? Welcome back to the channel and welcome to another music video reaction, continuing our series of delving into and dissecting and trying to rank and canonize, I guess, the greatest pop songs of all time. It's a series of reactions I've been doing for a few months now in this channel, in preparation for potentially compiling a list of maybe 250 songs or 500 songs more realistically, or maybe even 1,000 songs, or maybe just 100 songs to keep it simple, of what I believe to be the greatest pop songs of all time through a confluence of chart success, commercial performance, mainstream visibility, cultural impact, my personal opinion, all that good stuff. And so this reaction is Maroon 5, She Will Be Loved. One of Maroon 5's signature songs, of course, we could talk about This Love, Makes Me Wonder, which is my personal favorite from them, Moves Like Jagger. Of course, they have a string of widely successful hits in the 2010s, which are not nearly as good, but She Will Be Loved is definitely one of their signature songs. It was the third single from their 2002 debut album, Songs About Jane, and we will look at the chart success right now. So it peaked at number 5 on the Hot 100, number 4 on Adult Contemporary, number 1 on both the Adult Top 40 and Mainstream Top 40, and now for the year-end charts for 2004, 35 on the year-end Hot 100, 47 on Adult Contemporary, 17 on Adult Top 40, and 13 on Mainstream Top 40. For 2005, 61 on the Hot 100, 5 on Adult Contemporary, 12 on Adult Top 40, 82 on Mainstream Top 40. Decade end, for 2000s, number 20 on the Adult Top 40, and it is certified 4x platinum here in the U.S. So again, one of their signature songs, definitely a contender for a list of the greatest pop songs of all time, especially, you know, the more you stretch out the list to like 250 or 500, or even, especially, you know, 1,000 songs. But enough chatter, let's dive in. Make sure that's turned up. If it doesn't buffer. There's Adam Levine diving into the swimming pool. Oh, a little too loud. Now I'll try. I'm so indecisive. Beauty queen of only 18, she had some trouble. Like those keys in the background. Sorry, it's so hard not to sing along. It's a good song. So, heading into the second verse now, a couple of things that stand out so far. You know, when you think about Maroon 5, I feel like, especially in their prime, I feel like the lyrics can be kind of love-worn. I feel like Adam Levine does a really good job of, like, slipping into the role of, like, the restless, uncaged lover. Or sexually unruly lover, or disgruntled ex-lover, whatever you want to call it. But this song, by comparison, compared to like Makes Me Wonder or Misery or Wake Up Call, here he is showing a sort of like intimacy and vulnerability that kind of, I think, juxtaposes in a good way the sort of more brash, cocky, cocksure sort of arrogance. And I mean it all in a good way. The kind of arrogance that you see on the rest of Songs About Jane. And even the band's founding drummer, Ryan Dusick, who is in this video and, you know, recorded the song, he even referred to Adam in his book as, like, cocksure. Like, when he met Adam in high school, Adam was, like, an acne-faced, insecure teenager. And then Adam kind of, like, you know, as he grew up, he had more of an ego, And so I don't think this song counteracts that persona and identity. I think it juxtaposes and balances things out in a good way. Showing, you know, a more softer, I guess, tender side of Maroon 5. Like, definitely, like, much more adult contemporary oriented compared to the very heavy, by comparison, Harder to Breathe. You know, which was the debut single, lead-off single from this album. And is more rooted, I guess, in the band's grunge influences. I mean, again, by Adam and the band's own admission, they were influenced by Pearl Jam, Nirvana, Tool, Alice in Chains, Soundgarden. Adam Levine actually did a summer camp with the guitarist, I forget his name, from the Dillinger Escape Plan, which is a pioneer of metalcore. So, like, even though like this song has way more artistic vision and more attitude and more humanity than any of their modern pop singles, you can definitely see a healthy artistic deviation here from songs like Harder to Breathe. How poignant those keys are. So that is She Will Be Loved by Maroon 5. So yeah, like I felt bad for, you know, pausing it early on and going on my little spiel about what I think of the song artistically. Like, you know, it's got a tightness to it, you know, especially from a composition standpoint. I mean, that might not be saying much because, again, they're modern, you know, pop Walmart core-centric singles are pretty much devoid of any live organic instrumentals. So maybe to say that this song is, you know, tighter and has more attitude or whatever might not be saying much. It's like it's the tallest kid in kindergarten compared to songs like Sugar or Animals or Beautiful Mistakes. But this song, I think, is indicative of why Maroon 5 were such a unique and cool band. Like, and again, in Adam Levine's own words, like, they didn't even know what they were at first. They were a rock band playing R&B music. But it is a unique and original idea, or at least it was when they first came out. And I think this song is the best exemplar of that. I mean, you can't go wrong with the original presentation, because it's a sound that was all their own, which makes it all the more frustrating that they completely gave up on it to chase trends. But hey, at least they made a fuck ton of money, right? But this is such a great song. You know, it's got an intimacy and a vulnerability that you don't really see elsewhere in the Maroon 5 canon. Not even in their older stuff. And it is, again, I think a great exemplar of that soft, tender, adult contemporary shtick that they really smashed out of the park, especially in their early years. It's a great song and deserving of being one of their signature songs. What do you think of She Will Be Loved by Maroon 5? Let me know what you think about it in the comments below. If you enjoyed this reaction, please like, subscribe, hit the bell to get notified when another video drops. We'll see you on the next one. Take care, everyone.